una carrera brillante.
¡Te amo, Buenos Aires!
Y encima nos ama. Señoras, señores, de esta forma da comienzo el show de Glenn Hughes.
Keep moving along.
Southern blood.
Give it up. Ben Hughes en vivo desde el Teatro Motrix.
So sweet.
Sing Buenos Aires, sing.
Oh, you're too kind. You're too kind. You're too kind. I love this city. I love you people. You're very important in my life. I like to carry the message to you every time I'm here. Rock music is not dead, people.
Let me hear you say, yeah. Yeah. Let me hear you say, yeah, yeah, yeah. Yeah, yeah.
Here's a song I wrote in 1982. It's called. is when you make it seem real. Oh, don't you fake it anymore. I really can't take it, that's for sure. Sublime. Cry and shame. The seventh step.
Te amo, G.
Okay, I played this place about 3 years ago with Kings of Chaos, and I just want to tell you that this is the first show in South America, and this is a really important thing for me to tell you that when I first came to Argentina 22 years ago, I came to this beautiful city and I fell in love with everybody here. Thank you so much for your love and support.
We gotta carry the message, people. We gotta carry the message. So let's talk about...
I want to honor the band that was inducted into the Rock and Roll Hall of Fame this year. And I'm talking about Deep Purple. Ow, ow, ow. I need some water. I need some water. Give me some water. Thank you, Mike. And I love you too, brother and sisters.
So give it up for some Deep Purple, yeah? Yeah. Buenos Aires, let me hear your voice. Yeah. Louder. Yeah. Louder.
There's Gracias, amigos, amigas. Yeah, I can feel it. How you doing there? Yeah, I can feel that white, I can feel it. The white light, white heat. How you doing, buddy? Yeah. It's a beautiful, beautiful day here today. I wouldn't want to be anywhere else in the whole world other than right here, right now. I'm gonna speak very slowly because right now is the only thing that matters to me, not tomorrow or yesterday. Right now, standing in front of you, my friend, you right there, yeah, you. Me singing to you. My friends in Buenos Aires, in Argentina, all around Argentina this evening, people are watching. Music is the healer. Music is the healer. We live in a dark time on our planet. The one thing that we can give and give back to each other, the only thing, and look at this shit right here, is music. We go home at night, we put our headphones on, and we listen to the music that we love, because music is the healer. Can you feel it, Buenos Aires? Let me hear you say, yeah. I'm gonna speak even slower. I wrote this next song when I was 17 years old in my grandmother's kitchen. She was making dinner for my parents. I was a young boy, very long hair and long legs. Longer hair than this. So this is the first rock song I wrote when I was a teenager, recorded by two bands, Trapeze and Black Country Communion. Te amo. I'm all yours, Argentina. My heart is yours.
No way.
exclusivo Porterix.com.
I love you, brother. How do you feel? All I care about is how you feel. I feel pretty good myself tonight. in the Vortirix, in a famous little place. We all love to play here in Buenos Aires. So everybody, I have a new Glenn Hughes album coming in November. The first Glenn Hughes album in 8 years. Buenos Aires, the next Glenn Hughes album is fucking heavy as fuck. I'm gonna rock your fucking world, motherfuckers. How you feel? Buenos Aires, let me know how you feel. Let me know how you really feel, come on. Yeah, louder, 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 oh yeah.
Yeah, I wanna see them howl. I wanna hear you howl.
thank you. Thank you so much. That's the first song I wrote for Black Country Communion.
Yeah? Switch. I have to switch bases.
Okay. So I want to talk about this next song I'm going to play. So, this is a Deep Purple song, okay? And so I joined the band in the summer, early summer of 1973. Yes, it's a long time ago. Hey, Anita. 2 months after I joined, a guy called David Coverdale came in after me. David Coverdale is one of my closest friends to this very, very day. I love him like my family. So he came to stay with me and my mom and dad and my grandma. I am an only child. So he came to my house and we wrote this next song. We wrote this song. It was going to be on the album called Burn. But it didn't make that album. It didn't make it, but it made it onto Come Taste the Band, featuring the late, great John Lord. Come on. And the late, great Tommy Bolin. Let's hear for Tommy. Let's hear for Tommy. So, this is the song that David and I wrote for Burn that made it onto Come Taste the Band. And if you want to, I know you know this song. If you're a Deep Purple fan or you're a Glenn Hughes fan or David Coverdale fan, you know this song and I love you so much. I want to thank each and every person in this room for the life that you have given to me. And I give all my love, every single moment of my life, back to you. I love you, Argentina. God bless you. And keep you safe. And be free, people. Be free. The world needs to be free.
Hey!
Will you meet me there? And I know nothing will matter because I'm all.
Thank you.
Aplastante show de Glenn Hughes. Hasta aquí en el Teatro Vorterix. Impecable, gallo, impecable.
Tremendo. ¿De qué aldea sacaron este duende loco que se llama Glenn Hughes, que agradece con la cabeza gacha y los brazos abiertos en el borde del escenario? Realmente un concierto impecable con una lista que no es hitera, hay que decirlo.
Es verdad, una lista que no tiene tal vez canciones conocidas para aquel que escucha Deep Purple en la radio.
Claro, que escucha Deep Purple y que no escuchó los otros proyectos.
Dios bendiga a todos. Impecable,
I'll see you next year, people. I love you so much.
Los veo el año que viene.
No, señor.
Gracias,
no se
vaya. Amigos, sí, amigas.
Va una hora y cuarto de show, Glenn. Volvé, no te vayas. Hasta aquí han pasado 11 canciones. Tenemos Way Back to the Bone, de Trapeze, aquel primer proyecto que tuvo antes de Deep Purple. Después tenemos Muscle and Blood, de ese proyecto que yo te comentaba en un comienzo, que se llama Hugh Trall, con Pat Trall,
sí,
el violero de Asia y de Meatloaf. Un proyecto que duró poquito, porque solo pudieron tocar 17 shows porque estaban drogados los dos hasta el demonio. Y dijeron, negro, no puede volver así. Así que nunca más tocaron. Después Orion, del disco Soul Mover, un disco solista de Glenn. Touch My Life, de Trapeze. First Step of Love fue la quinta de Hugh Strahl, otra vez. Stormbringer, creo que no hace falta aclarar no a quién pertenece. Medusa, de Trapeze. Can't Stop the Flood, temazo del disco Building the Machine, otro trabajo solista de Glenn. One Last Soul, de Black Country Communion, un hit radial que tuvo Black Country Communion. You Keep On Moving, una versión maravillosa.
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 Con el público cantando encendidísimo, bueno, sí, un viejo clásico de Purple.
Exactamente, él contó que lo habían compuesto con Coverdale en la casa de la abuela.
En la cocina de la abuela.
Exactamente, en la cocina de la abuela para el disco Burn, finalmente terminó entrando en el disco Come Taste the Band. Y el tema número 11, Soul Mover, del disco homónimo, un trabajo solista. Lamentablemente, tengo que decir que quedan dos canciones, nada más. Un clásico actual y un clásico eterno, de esos que están inscriptos en letras doradas en la historia del rock and roll. Sabrán imaginarse ustedes cuáles. Así que quedan dos canciones nomás para disfrutar de Glenn Hughes. Un tipo que tiene 65 años, que tiene una trayectoria intachable y que aún así sigue vigente, sigue editando música, sigue componiendo para dos proyectos, no solo para uno, como es su trabajo solista, sino que el próximo año saldrá un disco de Black Country Communion, que fue una banda realmente interesante dentro de ese proyecto que tuvo con Joe Bonamassa, Derek Sherinian y Jason Bonham.
Sí, ¿no? Creo que lo que conspiró contra Black Country fue el tiempo donde sale el disco. Tiempos sí modernos donde todo se mezcla menos para elegir y por ahí algunas cositas se pierden. Nos quedan dos canciones, como decía el gallo, Glenn Hughes, su nombre escrito con luces rojas ahora, bien marcadito en la parte final, la pared, lo que sería del escenario, formato sí de trío, para aquel que nos escuche y no nos ve, un formato de trío con Guido Zuller en la batería, algo así como una novedad, ¿no?
Igual, Guido Zuller en la batería y un Chardino joven, ¿no? En viola.
Sí, señor. Sí, señor. Con muchos contactos, decíamos, con el gallo, con Ricky Faulkner,
sí,
el actual guitarrista de Judas Priest. Y este es el cántico del público. A ver, escuchemos. Sí.
Un público que también ovacionó a John Lord y a Tommy Bolin. Tommy, olé, olé, Tommy, Tommy. Una cosa insólita ya, que Tommy Bolin se lleve un olé, olé. No, alguien que murió hace casi 40 años.
Casi 40 años. Ahora sí, la parte final, las dos que quedan. Glenn Hughes en vivo en Vorterix.
Prophecy.
en vivo desde el Teatro Motrix.